Howdy, fellas. Frankie Day here from YouTube. Okay, guys, the topic for this evening's YouTube presentation is going to be three more kits from my stash pile. And these will be used for future builds when they arise. And so I got three odd kits right here. One of them is not too odd, but they're generally not presented here too much on YouTube that I know of. But anyway, I bought these today. But starting out with this one, fellas, this one don't need too much introduction to it anyway, guys. This kit's been around for a long, long time. I mean, I retract that statement. I shouldn't say that. I mean, I haven't seen this kit and for a long, long time, for many years. At least 37 years is the last time I've seen this kit. This is by the AMT, the original kit that produced this kit. This is the reboxing of their 1975 release, right after the movie was made, of the Hindenberg. And it's a scale of 1/5/20, which renders 18.5 inches long. And as a Daniel kit, also includes with the kit, guys, is they give you a C-47, is a Dakota, and the wingspan of that is a little more than 2.25 inches long. So it's pretty small, so it actually is good for comparison scale. And I built one of these a long, long time ago, and many years ago, actually, when it first came out. And instead of using the kit stand, like this kit here too, I'm gonna shit can the stand, throw it in the shit can, and don't have to worry about it. And I go ahead and build me a wire frontier that'll fit in front of the nose, give a simulation that's flying. Then on the base plate, I'm going to have that DC-3 use the piano wire. I have it flying around over it like it's taking pictures. So it's going to be a one-of-a-kind diorama. And this is a good kit, guys. And I opened this thing about twice, went through it already. And I know pretty much by heart now. Don't give very many pieces, folks. Starting out in general, they give you the hull. Is a right and left section that completes the hull. That's 18.5 inches long, and it's a very, very detailed and well-presented hull. And there's a rubber band right here. Get close, folks. You can see the rubber band right here where it's held together. Take a rubber band, it'll fall apart. But it's more or less put in there to keep it secure and from bouncing around breaking parts off, which is a pretty good shipping method on their part. And the texture on the skins on the lingeries is very highly detailed. And I'll tell you one thing, I kid you not, folks. You put some aluminum paint on this, airbrush aluminum paint on this, and gloss it over, and use a good wash on it, and control that wash effect by using a damp towelette or a damping rag, a nice soft rag. You can control the fidelity of detailed texture of the dope fabric that actually was on. And the instructions are nothing but straightforward. It shows you instructions right here of the Hindenburg. Excuse me, folks. My apologies. Right side up. The assembly. And, well, the instructions I have not looked at. But that's it right there, folks, of the instructions they give you. That completes the kit. Everything else is symbols and history and everything, and up to his demise. And also in the baggie, it contains a very few parts. It contains a horizontal stabilizers that control the Hindenburg up and down. And it comes with the engines, the props. There's a gondola right there. And right over here, folks, is a C-47 right here. If we get a little closer, you can see it. And it's right about here. Right there. Where our finger's at. I want to take that out of this bag. There you go, folks. You see it right there? That's 1/5/20 scale. Wingspan's only about 2.25 inches. In spite of the instructions in the baggie, here's the parts. Here's the base plate for the stand. Like I said, this is the second time I built this. I'm going to build this kit. And this goes whew, right in the trash can. The decals are very good. Now, when I first seen this box top, I took home and looked at it. I said, oh man, those swastikas, what am I going to do? And I opened up the decal sheet and looked at it very carefully. Here's the decals right above the circled, the white circled red hexagon right here. up here, you can see the swastikas right there. They come in pieces. You got to assemble them. I'll tell you one thing. I'm very happy that AMT has done that, so you can be able to put them on there. You make it more authentic, and like the way it's supposed to be. But that includes the inbox review of the AMT 1/5/20 scale, Great Late Hindenberg dirigible. And also, it's really cool too. I like very much also the back of folks. They give you a nice painting of it right here. When it's at nighttime, the brilliance of the Hindenburg, a nice starlit sky with spotlights, that really enhances it. It really enhances the model very much. And that'd be that for there. And it's a good model, and I highly recommend it. So that would be a great collection for your airship enthusiasts who like to build airships in general. And I like them once in a while. It'd be a good group build for wings and things or something like that. That'd be a good subject for it. Okay, secondly, guys, this is kind of out of character anyway, and material-wise. This is a balsa wood kit, which I'll be building here in U2 also. I was thinking about making this thing a free flight job where I could fly it. Now, this is by the Dumas Company, which they're famed for making model boats. This is the Wendell Williams Gilmore Racer, Red Lion Racer. And this is a very odd shaped aircraft. It was a very potent airplane. It was back in the golden age of aviation back in the 1930s. And I've never seen it flying a couple times. The wingspan of this airplane is only 24 inches long. It's a balsa wood kit. The construction consists of nothing more than stringers and launcher rods and wing ribs and tissue. So there's not much for inbox review in this kit here. So I got this right here, and so I can be able to build it, I can be able to fly it. So I'm very considering next year I'm going to take this thing and fly it and get my camera out there and have my wife hold the camera for me while I fly this. That'd be a pretty good thing for you fellas to look at. It'd be something different. I'll put this aside over here, gang. So, I'm very, apologize not giving an inbox with you and that kit right there. It's just nothing but balsa wood, instructions, wire, everything can make this airplane happen. So, this one I will give an inbox with you. And I sent some on a Titanic kick and went and broke down and got this today. I think I paid $35 for this kit. This is the RMS Titanic in a scale of 1/700 scale. Now, what makes this kit so significant, what I really enjoy the most, there's hardly any painting you really do on it. The kit comes pre-painted already, and generally in most parts that need painting most are pre-painted. Now, this is 1/700 scale. I like that little cellar window right there it gives you. That reminds me of the old Lindbergh models. When you can buy the Lindberghs, you know, you looked at, you peered to the windows and see all the parts there and stuff. And that was kind of really exciting with, you know, us young guys when we were younger once upon a time. Now, the instructions are, I looked at the kit before, guys, before making this video, so I know what I'm dealing with. The kit is very, very, it's elementary. You don't take too much great skill to build this. It's a small scale, and it's pretty well prefabbed together. And detail-wise, it's excellent. So, for 1/700 scales, guys, this will make an excellent, very excellent addition, especially to the Ravello Germany's RMS Olympic, which is her first sure sister ship's name. Okay, guys, once you open up the box, you read about the instructions. And they got tools, advertising there to buy tools and such. The hull itself looks like it's about 15 inches long. This is the hull. It's already painted all the way up to the promenade deck, from B-D deck all the way up to the boat deck. It's all been painted white already. And what's good about it is, folks, those portholes, every one of those portholes are drilled out. And it seems like to me there's a hole right there in the middle to allow light to pass through when this thing is sitting on a TV set or something. And light always, the power of light is, you never want to underestimate the power of light. Because when light travels, if there's an opening, it'll escape its way out. So that's a very good feature given this model here. Also, another good feature about too is for LEDs in here. that would really make it look nice. And there's plenty of room to also the bottom of the hull's got a hole there too. So eventually, I think this thing one time did have some kind of light source in it. Academy makes this model, guys, and to me, I'm not too familiar with it. It's the state of the art of ejection plastic model kits. There's the bottom section of the hull on there. It's our pre-painted red oxide. This is a very, very detailed model for 1/700 scale, and it's not really, it's not too big, and it's not too small. The Titanic was a very, very large ship. For her day, she was the largest moving object man-made has ever made. And they found out that this superiority of building something like this so colossal and so huge. That's when the arrogance came in and they say, hey, God himself can never sink this ship. We built this ship. This ship's infallible. It's unsinkable. It took 1,500 people to lose their life. And people who lost their families, 720 survivors, who lost their families on this ship. Ask them if their ship was infallible. Nothing's infallible. That was an arrogance on a man's part. So a lesson was learned. You never take something like this out and start running into ice full flank ahead and no lifeboats to accommodate everybody aboard this vessel. There's a horrible death, guys, be out there in 28 degrees seawater. Man, you hit that water in right there, it's over for you. You can be Jack Armstrong, the All-American boy, or Jack LaLanne, the champion swimmers. No matter how hardy you are, being submissive in that kind of water will take it out of you, man. You'd be done in no time. Ain't no way for nobody to die. Anyway, guys, the parts are very few here, too. They're all prefabricated kit. The funnels are there. They're kind of orange color, like orange-yellow, which I don't approve that color. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go ahead and prime that color and make it white star buff, the way it's supposed to. Now, here's another good feature, guys. You look up here, are nothing but benches, 1/700 scale. These are the benches, the deck benches, which ship's company and also the passengers would congregate and sit down and retire in for the day. Get some good sunshine on your hide. And also it comes with the props too. They're plated in gold plating, which really enhances the model. This is a super kit, guys. So I mean, for 1/700 scale and what you get and what I paid for, man, it's nothing to gripe about. I'm happy. Right there, the decks. The decks are all pre-colored too, all tan color. So I'm going to preserve the deck. With some parts of the ship I'll be painting, a lot of parts I'm not. So ain't no sense of god darn painting the thing all primed up and go ahead and paint it over again. I bought this kit for this purpose. It's a multicolored kit. Just limited painting is only used on this, and it still makes a very good looking model. And there's parts in there that's got to be painted individual. That's no problem because this is a very, very beautiful little model. I'm pretty happy with it, what I've seen it. So anyway, that's two baggies right there along with two hull sections you get. Lastly, on this white sprue, there's the compass antenna platforms on there, which is here. The compass platform right there. And you got the bridge deck. You got the bow stern railing. And also you got your kickboard stands on it. You got 16 of those David lifeboats and Whaling davits on there. Those ship's boats are very detailed. In general, guys, this is a very detailed kit. It's very detailed. I mean, I'm very pleased with this kit, what I've seen. Anyway, fellas, that completes the inbox review of the RMS Titanic by Academy on a scale of 1/700. I very highly recommend this kit. This kit is a very beautiful kit, and it won't break your wallet, guys. So $35, hey, that's... I mean, it's... And it's all already painted for you already? Can't beat it. And then also, another feature, too, I forgot, may I ask, too. Now, this is optional right now. If you guys, if you decided, a lot of people like build, like I'm for one, you got a ship model that's I like to build my ships when they're underway. And it's elements. It gives it character. It gives it scale. And what else? It's capturing the model itself and its elements. What's good about this here, guys, if you sided, I don't want no full hull, bottom hull, I don't want no screws to glue on, what I'm going to do, I'll get rid of this bottom section, get me some plasterine or some plastic, plaster, best yet, get yourself some Reynolds Wrap aluminum foil, crinkle up, stretch it out, burst out some of the parts of it, use contact cement, glue contact cement to it, and glue it down. You make a good waterline model, this thing underway. You can go one step further. You can make an iceberg out of styrofoam. Have it simulating hitting the bird. This model has a lot of possibilities, but you can be done with it. And general guys, this is a very nice cat. I'm very pleased with it, with the Givia. It's really detailed. It don't look jumbled up. It's all prefabricated. It goes together without a fuss, no sweat. Very inexpensive. And it's probably at your hobby shop near you. And it's by Academy. It comes in a box, this box again. I imagine this is probably a limited edition kit. It's supposed to be the 100 years bicentennial of these. Of the demise of the RMS Titanic. Okay, guys, that completes the three kits in my stash, added to the stash, and those are going to be future builds, guys. Each one of those models will be built here on YouTube, and I got a lot on here that needs to be done doing. So right now I'm trying to catch up on my model shipbuilding, and it warms up some more after the winter blows in. I'll be going back to plastic airplanes again. Of course, I'll be building plastic wintertime anyway, because I'll start getting burned out building card models for a while. I'll go right back into plastic, so I'm pretty versatile. So I've got all kinds of material and models that can be treated differently, like the build. So they're not going to go, they ain't going nowhere, but staying right in here. Anyway, guys, this is about it for me for tonight, so be sure to review my final reveal for Craig Huff's World War I group build. I'd like to thank Mr. Greg Huff from England, and God bless him, and God bless you, Greg. Thank you very much, dear sir, for letting me be your participant in your group build, and I may sneak another one in your group build. You don't know what I'll do. My mind changes every day. I say, what's that the heck? You know, I got nothing but time left. I'll go ahead and build this and build that. So, whatever comes to mind. So, anyway, I like to finish up my plate before I get started and anything else. And believe you me, I got a lot on my plate, guys. And, so I got a lot of stuff coming your way, guys. Okay, guys, this is right now. It's time for you to get out of here. I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in. And may God bless. Happy modeling. Remember, make mama happy. And we'll catch you on the next video. It should be my Tanty Jew, my Yonkers 52. I have another video of that in another day or so. So you can stay tuned for that video. So I got a bit of that coming up for you guys to watch. And I'll be right now checking out your guys' videos. Okay, guys, time for you to get out of here right now. This is Frankie Day signing off. May God bless. Happy modeling. We'll catch you all in the next video. You boys do good now. See you, man. Take care, fellas.